I was always interested in the sciences and biology, and particularly pre-medical studies. I do intend on going into medical school. So what really made me decide to come to Hofstra was their pre-medical program, because recently it has enhanced a lot, especially with the building of the medical school. And we've been working a lot with them. So I'm also the president of the Association of Pre-Health Oriented Students and the Pre-Health Scholar Coordinator. And it's been a great experience. I am interested in going into obstetrics and gynecology because, one, I simply think the process is amazing, but also because my interest in medicine really revolves around a combination of surgery and medicine. And I feel like with obstetrics and gynecology, you get the both of that. I was the coordinator for the Pipeline Medical Scholars Program during the summer of my sophomore year. And so I was working at the medical school with the Pipeline Scholars, and that's where I met Dr. Frankfurt, and she was doing research at the time on estrogen and spine densities, as well as she also did the behavioral studies, so their role in memory and cognition. Once I spoke to her and she told me about her research, I was really interested in it, and she gave me a literature review article that she had recently published. I read it and I was so excited about it. I talked to her about it the next day, and after that she asked me to do research with her, and I took her up on it. Well, estrogen has been widely known that it has effects in the reproductive system. I mean, it's a steroid hormone. But it also has effects on cognition. So there are on neurons, on their dendrites, their spines, and these spines have receptors. And estrogen has a role in altering the morphology of those spines. It can have a role in altering your cognition and memory, so enhancing that long-term speaking. What I really did was count those spine densities and see the alterations in those spine densities in different brain regions. So I looked at the arcuate nucleus and the ventral medial nucleus in overactimized female rodents. And what that means was that they had their uterus removed, so we had to treat them with estrogen. And then I counted the spine densities within their brains. So my research will actually be published, what I have actually contributed at least, will be published eventually within a literature review article that a collaborator of my research professor, Dr. Victoria Lewin, is working on. So these results will be available to the public. There was a novel finding in my research in the sense that we found that BPA actually has an effect on spine densities without estrogen being there. We would really expect to see BPA's effects on spine densities with the presence of estrogen, since BPA works on estrogen's receptors. However, in this study we found that in the arcuate nucleus, BPA can work alone on altering the spine densities. And that's new because we've never seen that before and nobody really expected that. Well, I was really lucky that I was able to branch out and work with the School of Medicine on my research. And there have been other students who were also able to work with Feinstein Institute on their research. And it's really nice to be able to do research on something you love and you are passionate about. The Pre-Health Scholars Program is actually a new program that is designed to work with the pre-medical students and gear them towards medical school specifically. So at Hofstra we have APHOS, which is for pre-health students in general, so pre-vet, pre-dent, all of that. But pre-health scholars is really for pre-med students. Because I'm the coordinator, I was able to schedule events with the medical school. We have key issue sessions with Dr. Gannon. So you already get exposure to the School of Medicine even as an undergrad. And we also visit different medical schools. So recently we visited NICOM, which was really nice because once you meet the deans and you actually meet the faculty, you get to know more about medicine and how, I guess, the work ethic you're supposed to have as an undergrad in order to get into medical school. They always say that medicine, if you want to go into medicine, you have to be a lifelong learner. And that's something I really feel as though I am. I love to learn new things. I love to learn about new discoveries, which is probably why I actually chose my science major.